In this section, we're going to talk about various ways to show screens in pop-up windows. We're going to do a few examples on the screen windows screen that we created. So if you're following along in the TIA portal, open your screen windows screen. First thing we'll do is drag out a button. When we click this button, what we want to do is show the welcome screen in a pop-up dialog. So we'll go to properties. And then for our text, we will just do show welcome screen. Now, if you want to make that a multi-line button, you can do shift enter. And notice that that gives us multi-line, so either way. And then for events, on click left mouse button, we're going to add a function. We'll show our list. And of course, we're going to go to screens. And we will just do open screen and pop-up. Now it's going to ask us for a pop-up window name, and this is actually going to be the name of the pop-up window object that is showing the screen. So we're just going to give it something here. Let's just call it pop-up window. And for the screen name, we'll access our list of screens and we'll just choose welcome and click the green checkbox. And then the header text, this is going to be the text displayed at the top of the pop-up window. So we'll just put pop-up welcome. The left and top are going to be your XY coordinates of the pop-up window when it comes up. For now, we'll just leave them at zeros and see what happens. So we'll save the project and go to runtime. So we'll go to screen windows, and when we click the button, it does show this as a pop-up. And it's pretty big. That's because your pop-up function automatically sizes the picture window object or the screen window object to be the size of the screen you give it. So if you give it a big screen, it's going to be big. If you give it a small screen, it's going to be small. And through the project function list, I don't think there's really a way to change that. So this is really only going to be useful for smaller pop-up screens because it tends to cover up your UI and it's not really a good way to do that. So for our next example, we'll just create a smaller pop-up screen called Motor 1 and use the same function and see how that reacts. So we'll go back into TIA portal, click add new screen, and go to properties. So on our height, we'll just make this 250 and we'll make the width 175. On our toolbox, under our graphics folder, you can pick a piece of equipment. I'm going to go to equipment, automation, motors, and then just drag a motor out. I'll resize it so it fits in the window. And if we want it to look nice, maybe add a text box. And we'll just save that. And then we'll rename that screen Motor 1. Going back to our screen window object, I'm just going to copy this button and then paste it. And then that way all we have to do is change the text and the name function. So I'll change welcome to Motor 1. And then on events, all I have to do is change my screen name. And I can just type this in as long as I spell it correctly. And then maybe for the header, we'll also change that to Motor 1. So we'll save that and go to runtime. Refresh. And go to screen windows. So we click the button and our Motor 1 pop-up appears, but it appears all the way up in the top left corner. And that's because we gave it coordinates 0, 0. You might have expected it to show up in the top left corner of our screen window, but it doesn't take into account whether it's being shown within a screen window on another screen or if it's on the base screen. So if you wanted to make this pop up right by the button, you would have to calculate the left position of your screen window screen, as well as the left position of your button, as well as the width of your button in order to get it to show up close. And that also doesn't take into account that we are actually scaling this window. So it's going to be a little difficult to be able to use the pop-up dialog if you want this to pop up directly by a button. So if I want to create a pop-up window that shows up by an icon or directly by a button without doing a lot of calculations and offsets that may not work once the user changes the base window size, how do I do that? Well, we can use a screen window object. So we'll go back to TIA portal and we're just going to add another button. And for the text here, I'll just put motor one pop-up near button. And what we'll do is under our controls, we'll take a screen window and we're going to place it kind of where we want it. And then in the properties under fit to size, we'll choose fit window and screen, which basically means it will take the size of the window we give it. And we are going to set the screen so we can just type in, and as we start typing, it's going to give us a filter. So we'll just pick out motor one. And then most importantly, we're going to go down to visibility. Now, one of the things that you're going to find out is when we are using a project function or later on the course scripts to set a property, what you see here is not necessarily going to be the name that you'll use for that property. So we're going to right click and we're going to do copy property name. So this is going to be something very important for you to remember. So I'll right click and I'll just do copy. Now once we've copied that, I'm going to uncheck it, which basically means this window will be invisible. So for this example, when I click the button, we're going to set the visibility property of this window to true or one, and it's going to show the pop-up. And then when we want it to go away, we'll click the X. Well, how do we do this? We'll go back to the button, and on events, we'll go to our function list. And then under screen, there is going to be a function called setPropertyValue. So we'll select that, and it's asking us for a screen object path and a screen object property name. So let's tackle the path first. If we go to this last select type, we want to access a screen object. So we'll choose screen object, and then it's going to give us a list of all the objects. And the screen window one, which is this pop-up screen, that's the object that we want to set a property on. So then the next one is, what is the property name? This is where I can use my control V to paste in. And when I did the copy on the visibility property, we find that the name of that property is actually visible. Lastly, for our value, if we want to show it, it needs to be a one, which is equal to true. So we'll just save this and we'll go to runtime. And I'll go to our screen windows, and you'll see that our pop-up is right by the window. So using a screen window object is a very easy way to create a pop-up, especially if you're using screen window technology. So now it's your turn. I would like you to create the pop-up screens that we did in this video. Add a button to your screen window screen, which will create a pop-up for your welcome screen, or feel free to use another screen. And then create a smaller equipment screen like we did with our Motor 1 example, and add a button to show that using the pop-up function. Finally, add a button and a screen windows object to the screen windows screen and set the following properties on your screen window. Set your screen to your smaller Motor 1 screen and set the visibility property to 0. Then on the button, use the set property function to make your screen window visible. And then test your functionality in runtime. Go back and review the video if you need to know how to do these steps. Good luck.